You'll be doing Botclad a favor if you can clear out that pass. Why, I dare say, they'll give you a hero's welcome.
I'm not sure I trust those two. But if there are bandits lying in wait, I should probably take care of them.
Look lively, you lot!
Well, we've got guests!
These must be our bandits. Them dealt with. Now, where's that cart? When did you get so big? Getting all of this out of here will be a nightmare.
Seems we found ourselves the right man for the job, wouldn't you say?
Found the cart and didn't leave a single bastard breathing. Our merchant friend will be delighted.
And how exactly will he be getting his goods out of here?
You leave that to us. After all,
it'd be wrong to make such a fine warrior haul cabbages to market.
You've done your part. And that's all you need to worry about. Here. It's been a pleasure. Now piss off.
There's no need to be so rude, brother. What if we want his help again next time?
Cracked the crystal too. You're joking.
Trouble with the ledgers. Shouldn't he be asking Otto for help? With Torgor. He seemed well enough when I last saw him. Hopefully it's nothing. But I should speak to Blackthorn just in case.
Few more things to pack before I leave. I'll meet yous down in Buckland.
and got your note. You think something's wrong with Torgal?
So you can read. Congratulations. But I didn't say I were wrong with him. I said something weren't right. He's not been eating me treats. He used to love cracking the bones from Molly's boiled brown, but now he won't so much as look at them. Didn't like him. Which is why I'm of a mind that his mind's on something else. You've not been working him too hard, have you?
No harder than usual. Is that it, boy? Do you need a rest?
What was it you said he was? A frost wolf?
That's what the Lawsman seems to think.
Then maybe this all has something to do with whatever it is that's woken inside him.
I suppose things happen different since Rosaleth. Perhaps Harpocrates knows something.
Instead of everything, you mean? Perhaps.
Lawsman, I need to ask you about Torgal. Something's not right with him.
He isn't ill, is he?
I don't think so. But according to Lady Karen, he seems to have lost his appetite, which is certainly a new development. She says he's hardly been touching his bones of late, and she believes it may have something to do with what happened at Rosaleth Castle.
I rather think she might be right, though not about his appetite. All canids are instinctively inclined to crack open bones for the rich marrow that resides within, and I see no reason why a frost wolf should be any different. Accordingly, I suspect it is not a lack of appetite that afflicts Torgal, but a surfeit of it. If we assume that his newfound magics require additional nourishment to sustain, it may well be that the bones Lady Karen is accustomed to providing are no longer sufficient. Frost wolves, after all, habitually prey upon far larger animals, whose bones may yield altogether different nutrients. As to where one might find a suitable substitute, some antelopes that graze the meadows of eastern Rosaria have been known to grow to a size more than double that of their lesser cousins.
I don't recall ever seeing any that large.
And little wonder. The oldest and largest such creatures rarely leave the safety of the highlands for fear of predators. The last elder antelope sighting I recall hearing about took place near Cressida, and that was long before the village was abandoned.
Even so, it seems like a good place to start.
Good hunting, Clive.
She was building a ship.
Thank you.
Here. Greetings, Your Majesty.
Thank you.
campaign is over. Now to collect the ash. This looks like the stuff. Let's see if there's any more. That should do it. If a wine needs more than this, he can fetch it himself.
Is that the thing Tomes helped to build?
Yeah. He said it was some sort of genius.
I don't know where Cid gets the energy.
I went up to give some greens to the chocobo.
I could take one of our birds.
All right there, Cid. How's that hunt for the bomb ash going?
I have it here.
That's the stuff, and plenty of it too. Enough to keep the alembic bubbling away for a good old while. You're a gent, Cid. Let none say otherwise. Right then, let's get this contraption up and running. Telamon Malembic. And it works just like the chief said it would.
Very impressive.
Says the man who cut down a burning boulder. Speaking of which, I still haven't returned a favor.
There's no need. The good it will do for the hideaway is reward enough.
Don't be silly. Why don't you let me take a look at that bag of yours? The one you keep your potions in. Reckon I could work some magic on that, huh?
What kind of magic?
Well, we happen to have isolated a substance in our test run of the alembic that I reckon will make even the toughest lever supple as anything. Thought we might use it to breathe new life into old boots and the like. Save the hideaway a few gil. But I reckon if we slap a bit on your bag, it'll loosen it up enough for you to squeeze in a bottle or two more.
Well, it can't hurt to try, I suppose.
That's the spirit! Leave it with me. I'll only be a mo. Well? What do you reckon?
It certainly feels more of flexible.
Right? Told you.
Thank you. I think.
No. Thank you. for supporting Mid and the rest of us in our endeavors. Without you, we'd never have been able to discover wonders like that stuff I rubbed on your bag. And I'm telling you, there's plenty more where that came from.
Welcome to the Patron's Whisper. Your benefactors are a generous lot. Come again. I may have more for you.
Mid told me she was building a ship.
Really? Is that the thing Tomes helped to build?
And what can I do for you? If you're gonna buy something, be quick about it. I reckon I can find a buyer. I'll be thankful you got that much. You got out else? I'll be thankful you got that much. Come again. Oh, don't. I'm not much but... Well, don't just stand there gawping. You'll not find a better price than that. It'd better all be here. You'll not find a better price than that.
Is that all?
Thank you, Clive.
Is that the thing Tomes helped to build?
Mid told me she was building a ship.
Clive! Did you get my letter?
That's why I'm here.
Shh! Otto won't be listening.
Is this better?
A little. Listen. I've some bad news. It turns out the Hideaway may be slightly behind in its payment to certain lenders, and it may be my fault. But I swear to the goddess, I thought I had the numbers square. Sadly, that square turned out to be more of a circle. Zero, you might say. I can straighten it out, I swear, but it's going to take some time, and I'm going to need help keeping it from Otto.
Be late for that, I'd say.
There you are! What a surprise!
So let me get this straight. You forget to pay our lenders what they're due, and instead of coming straight to me, you get Clive to come to you. And I hope he'll dig you out of the hole you've dug for yourself. Clive! The man in charge of the place you've been cheerfully trying to bankrupt. And you thought this was a cunning plan. Why? Well, who needs paying?
Oh, just Martha. And the dame. And, well, Lady Karen. But only 500 talents.
We owe three of our most trusted friends 5 million gil.
Each. 5 million each. They lent us the bulk of the money we used to rebuild the Hideaway, you see, and, well, I must have made some sort of oversight.
Those ledgers were my responsibility, and it was my decision to entrust them to you. This is my fault.
Do we have that much to hand? I can always ask my uncle.
No, we don't. And no, you won't. We've lightened Lord Rosfield's purse enough. After the king's ransom we had off him, he deserves better than to see our begging bowl. Besides, we'll need to learn to stand on our own if we're going to make this work.
All right. But that doesn't mean you have to shoulder the burden yourself. Is there anything I can do to help?
There might be. How'd you fancy taking these to Martha and the dame?
Rocks.
Rocks, he says. Worth 1,000 talents apiece, these are.
A little something Sid and I set aside for when times got lean. And I reckon 15 million in overdue debt probably qualifies. I just hope our associates' eyes are a bit more discerning than yours.
I'm sure they will be.
Should be me making the rounds, really. But you know how it is with this place. Orders to bark, asses to wipe and all that.
I know. Which is why I don't mind going in your place.
Go. Do you know why I only gave Master Clive here 2 star rubies?
Because you'd rather Lady Karen killed me.
Because I'd rather Lady Karen killed you, yes.
Well, I suppose this is goodbye then.
Don't worry. I'm sure Karen will understand.
Really? Do you think so?
No, I don't.